Once upon a time, in a land far, far away. We all know these words, and we know what they signal. It's a fairy tale about to begin. But what exactly comes next? Is it a princess trying to find her prince? Or perhaps a poisoned apple and an evil queen who lives in a dark castle? What about the story of a girl who lives in a tower? We all know that one. But this girl can't get married until her suitor guesses every type of gum tree, every species of eucalyptus on her property. Probably not the fairy tale you were thinking of. How about the story of a boy who fights sharks in the Great Australian Bight and is guided by a wily, talking magpie? No, I'm not making these stories up. They're Australian fairy tales, and they're also what I'm researching. The aims of my research are twofold. Firstly, I want to demonstrate a sustained tradition of engagement with the fairy tale genre within Australian literature, from settlement all the way to the present day. This involves archival work through libraries and databases, and while I'm only in the early stages of my research, I've already found a vast body of texts which engage with fairy tale tropes, themes, and plots, yet set their tales within Australian landscapes. This leads to the second aim of my research, which is to investigate the creative treatment of Australian landscapes within these fairy tale works. Essentially, by exploring how the mundane Australian landscape is enchanted, I hope to explore one of the overlooked genres which Australian authors have used to negotiate our often problematic history and explore complex social issues. When people think of Australian literature, they often think of a harsh, gritty, realist novel set in the outback. But the fairy tale genre has been used since the 19th century to explore ideas and themes in a much more accessible way, especially for children. For instance, recent writing by local Perth author Sean Tan has sought to infuse suburbia, the place where most people now live, with magic. In doing so, Tan has been able to explore issues of immigration and culture, storytelling and tradition. Other recent fairy tale works, such as Alexis Wright's Swan Book, have sought to deal with the problematic relationship between Indigenous and non-Indigenous people. And by creating a fairy realm within the country, she has been able to more freely explore and express her very complex ideas. My hope is that this research will shed light on texts which have been forgotten from our past or overlooked in the present, and demonstrate the importance of the Australian fairy tale genre.